This is my piano.
No, I'm sorry. I'm just acting. Yes, like the selfish giant. Do you know the selfish giant? Yes, from Oscar Wilde's story. Well, don't worry, because today we're going to read The Selfish Giant by Oscar Wilde. Every afternoon, as they were coming from school, the children used to go and play in the giant's garden. It was a large, lovely garden with soft green grass. Here and there over the grass stood beautiful flowers like stars, and there were 12 peach trees that in the springtime broke out into delicate blossoms of pink and pearl, and in the autumn bore rich fruit. "How happy we are here," they cried to each other. One day, the giant came back. He had been to visit his friend, the Cornish ogre. When he arrived, he saw the children playing in his garden. "What are you doing here?" he cried in a very gruff voice, and the children ran away. "My own garden is my own garden," said the giant. "Anyone can understand that, and I will allow nobody to play in it but myself." So he built a high wall all round it and put up a notice board. "Trespassers will be prosecuted." He was a very selfish giant. The poor children had now nowhere to play. They tried to play on the road, but the road was very dusty and full of hard stones, and they did not like it. "How happy we were there," they said to each other. Then the spring came, and all over the country there were little blossoms and little birds. Only in the garden of the selfish giant, it was still winter. The birds did not care to sing in it, as there were no children, and the trees forgot to blossom. The only people who were pleased were the snow and the frost. "Spring has forgotten this garden," they cried. "So we will live here all the year round."
"I cannot understand why the spring is so late in coming," said the selfish giant,
as he sat at the window and looked out at his cold, white garden.
"I hope there will be a change in the weather."
But the spring never came, nor the summer. The autumn gave golden fruit to every garden, but to the giant's garden, she gave none.
"He is too selfish," she said.
So it was always winter there. One morning, the giant was lying awake in bed when he heard some lovely music. It sounded so sweet to his ears that he thought it must be the king's musicians passing by. It was really only a little linnet singing outside his window. But it was so long since he had heard a bird sing in his garden that it seemed to him to be the most beautiful music in the world.
And a delicious perfume came to him through the open casement.
Ah, I believe the spring has come at last. Hey, said the giant, and he jumped out of bed and looked out.
What did he see? He saw a most wonderful sight. Through a little hole in the wall, the children had crept in, and they were sitting in the branches of the trees. The birds were flying about and twittering with delight, and the flowers were looking up through the green grass and laughing. It was a lovely scene. Only in one corner, it was still winter. It was the farthest corner of the garden, and in it was standing a little boy. He was too small that he could not reach up to the branches of the tree, and he was wandering all round it, crying bitterly. The poor tree was still quite covered with frost and snow, and the north wind was blowing and roaring above it.
"Climb up, little boy," said the tree, and it bent its branches down as low as he could. But the boy was too tiny, and the giant's heart melted as he looked out.
"Ah, how selfish I have been," he said. "Now I know why the spring could not come here. I will put that poor little boy on the top of the tree, and then I will knock down the wall, and my garden shall be the children's playground forever and ever."
He was really very sorry for what he had done. So he crept downstairs and opened the front door quite softly and went out into the garden. But when the children saw him, they were so frightened that they all ran away, and the garden became winter again. Only the little boy did not run, for his eyes were so full of tears that he did not see the giant coming. And the giant stole up behind him and took him gently in his hand and put him up into the tree. And the tree broke at once into blossom, and the birds came and sang on it, and the little boy stretched out his two arms and flung them round the giant's neck and kissed him. And the other children, when they saw that the giant was not wicked any longer, came running back, and with them came the spring.
"It is your garden now, little children," said the giant, and he took a great axe and knocked down the wall. "But where is your little companion?" he said. The boy I put into the tree."
"We don't know," answered the children. "He has gone away."
No. You must tell him to be sure and come here tomorrow," said the giant.
But the children said that they did not know where he lived and had never seen him before. And the giant felt very, very sad.
"How I would like to see him," he used to say.
Years went over, and the giant grew very old and feeble. He could not play about anymore, so he sat in a huge armchair and watched the children at their games and admired his garden. One winter morning, he looked out of his window as he was dressing. He did not hate the winter now, for he knew that it was merely the spring asleep, and that the flowers were resting. Suddenly, he rubbed his eyes in wonder, and looked and looked,
In the farthest corner of the garden was a tree quite covered with lovely white blossoms. Its branches were all golden, and silver fruit hung down from them. And underneath it stood the little boy he had loved. Downstairs ran the giant in great joy, and out into the garden. He hastened across the garden and came near to the child. And when he came quite close, his face grew red with anger. And he said,
"Who hath dared to wound thee?"
For on the palms of the child's hands were the prints of two nails, and the prints of two nails were on the little feet.
"Tell me, that I may take my big sword and slay him."
"Nay," answered the child, "but these are the wounds of love."
"Who art thou?"
said the giant, and a strange awe fell on him, and he knelt before the little child. And the child smiled on the giant and said to him, "You let me play once in your garden. Today you shall come with me to my garden, which is paradise." And when the children ran in that afternoon, they found the giant lying dead under the tree, all covered with white blossoms. I hope you have enjoyed this beautiful short story by Oscar Wilde. See you next time, friends, for another storytelling time.